Thank you for your very kind words and inspiring opening statement, Excellencies, Presidents, Ministers, Heads of International Government, International Organizations, distinguished board members, dear friends, and guests of the Center. I want to start by thanking Prime Minister Mark Rutte of the Netherlands for hosting the GCA, and to congratulate Dr. Patrick Verkooyen, CEO, at the helm of this new international organization. Every time we gather together, the climate situation is more severe and more alarming. As Patrick pointed out, we can also no longer escape 1.5 degrees Celsius, so we may just be able to stop the warming there. But the acceleration between now and when we reach 1.5 degrees is a terrifying prospect. At the same time, we have been living the great disruption of the terrible pandemic. Yet we know this is not the reason to delay climate action. Climate disasters have made already vulnerable communities even more exposed to the virus, creating risks for us all. Unfortunately, the fragility of agreements at COP21 has also shown up in finance. The $100 billion per year promise is yet to be met. Neither is it balanced, so the adaptation agenda is not adequately supported. This all creates a major confidence issues for developing countries. The Paris Climate Change Agreement is not the problem. It is precisely the framework we need. Our task now is to rebuild confidence and trust to work together under the Paris regime. We can do that by addressing key finance and ambition gaps at COP26 at Glasgow. We should be constantly seeking to raise ambition. All nations, large or small, north or south, could bring forward new efforts each and every year. We should create voluntary new platforms to promote ambition in this way, which could feature at every single COP. We cannot again find ourselves in 2025 wondering if all the countries will send NDCs, nationally determined contributions, or not, or if these NDCs are stronger or not. By the time we react, it will already be 2030. We could already be in a 1.5 degrees Celsius world by then. There is one important silver lining. A common thread among the latest NDCs gives hope. There has been a very considerable strengthening of ambition in adaptation. Adaptation really is coming of age. Countries are ready for new ambition on adaptation, and they are ready to much scaled up financing for adaptation too. The Africa Adaptation Acceleration Program, which was initiated by GCA and AFDB, is the most ambitious single adaptation program that was ever devised, with a strong support from President Akinwumi Adesina of AFDB, and this GCA, the AAAP, is a type of template for the ambition and the approach which we absolutely have to see scaling across all regions of the world and very quickly. GCA is moving on South Asia, on China, and we are scaling up our work with all the CVF, Climate Vulnerable Forum countries. COP26 is just around the corner. It is our opportunity to reaffirm confidence in the Paris Agreement. The CVF countries have been calling for a type of pact on the climate emergency for raising ambition to keep 1.5 degrees within reach, to accelerate adaptation, to ensure the promised finance is delivered. Such a pact would surely help mark out Glasgow as a success. Distinguished colleagues, thank you for responding to our invitation to be here with us today, and especially the newcomers from among our GCA friends. This is a show of support for the GCA and for the adaptation agenda. COP26 needs to make sure adaptation truly takes off. We also have to look well beyond COP. Our real mission is to change lives, make people and communities resilient, bring excitement back to the prospect that we adapt well, that we can actually build back better. I'm sure you will all agree that this floating office is no step backwards. So let's be bold. Let us be optimistic. Let us be collaborative. And I count on you all. Everywhere today on this planet, people are less safe, less secure, more exposed. I believe we have what it takes in this room to change that. The world is counting on us, and we cannot fail them. I'd like to close by thanking the very able, hardworking staff of the GCA, by thanking the whole board members, and by thanking again our friends, new and old. And I want to especially thank my fellow co-conveners. Thank you, Dr. Kristina Georgieva of IMF, for your incredible commitment to this agenda. And thank you, my good friend, Feike Sibesma, my fellow co-chair of the board. And the final thanks once more to Patrick Verkooyen. Keep up the great work. Let us all keep up the momentum. Thank you very much. And I count on your leadership. Patrick, I'm happy to hand it over back to you. Thank you.